This could not happen because they were when they studying in order to become great scholar, he needs to really go through big procedure on study scriptures. First, when children come in Gurukula, then first they read, learn all verses. So many verses from many shastras they are learning. And then after this, they are studying grammar for 12 years. And after studying grammar, they are studying commentaries of so many acharyas. And then they are bringing conclusion by themselves. So this is very, very big process. It's not that he just read book once and then he decided, okay, that's it. Or maybe he read books, just translation without purport because this is shorter. No, this, he went for so many years through deep studying. And these kind of scholars, they are normally also discussing with each other very often philosophy and quoting the verses. So he knew shastras very well. Superficially he knew. He knew what is written there. But we can see that he didn't really know so many times proper explanation. Because shastras and Vedas are here, they are here to tell us about God, to show us the way towards the God. But shastras are really revealed by pure devotees. That's the way how they were carried around. So if we don't hear shastras from the pure devotees, we may get wrong conclusion. Because every word, whichever is there, it may have many different meanings, and then each of these meanings, when it's put it in combination with some other word which is there, then it's also changing so many meanings. This was also shown a little bit before when Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was discussing with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu about this Atmarama verse. Sarvabhauma was so proud that he knew so many explanations of this Atmarama verse, but when he heard how many explanations Lord Chaitanya can give to this verse, this was something completely outside of this universe. Then he could see and understand that only Supreme Personality of Godhead can really know so many explanations and so many different combinations. So in order to not get into this trying to speculate what the verse may mean and try to find something from behind, we have our acharyas who were reading all scriptures and who came to the proper conclusion and who are explaining our shastras and telling us what is the proper conclusion, what we need to do, and what is the final goal of our life. And who is representative for us of all this acharya is Srila Prabhupada. We don't even need to go and read all explanation of acharyas, because Srila Prabhupada was the one who read it, who knew it, and who put it in all these purports in his books. In every verse he was giving us essence, what is really the most important, and how what point acharyas gave, and also in the same time, how this is applicable and understandable to us in a Western world. Because he was very much taking care that his preaching become relevant to us. Because if he was telling us same things, what, for example, Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati was telling to his congregation, to him, what he was preached, I don't think we would really understand a lot. So he came and he made sure that this is acceptable by us, all the shastras, that we can see them and read through them. So we can see now this Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he got mercy of the Lord and he became devotee. So he is reciting verses and he is reciting wrong. And he's explaining why he little bit changed this verse, because word mukti was reminding him, because word mukti, what it means, for probably you were listening this last week, but just a little bit short reminder, what this means, it's liberation, impersonal liberation, and this is the ultimate goal of Mayavadis. And now when he hears this word, that ultimate mukti, he immediately thinks about this ultimate goal merging with the Brahman, which he doesn't want anymore as a devotee. As a devotee, this is punishment for him. what he wants when he wants to serve the Lord and be in his association, what he has opportunity right now, so he definitely doesn't want this mukti. That's the reason why he's changing the shastras. But we can see here that Lord Chaitanya, he is not really approving his changing the shastras. Because shastras are having very, there is also in this Vedic society, when they are studying shastras, there is one system of protecting shastras of not being changed. They have some 5 levels of memorizing verses. Then this first level is like what we are memorizing verse, for example, Sarva Dharma Bhagritya Jama Mikam Sharanam Raja. That's this first level. And then this second level, how they memorize verse, they are memorizing them in infinitive. This is in a way of how Prabhupada gave translation word by word. Sarvaha Dharmaha. So then they, after they're memorizing all verses, then they're memorizing this second level in infinitive. Then they're having next level when they're memorizing in some combinations, like 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, or something like this. And then each and every level is a little bit more complicated, has more complicated formula how to recite the verse. And all this just that they would remember them properly, and that will not happen, that the Vedas become changed. Because we can see even in this example of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, who had good motive, he still had intention to change a little bit the shastras. And always may happen that someone comes and little bit change here, little bit change there, and then shastras are not having anymore the same meaning. And then it's all religion is changing, and it's not anymore proper religion, it's becoming something completely different. Because all these Vedas are given by Lord, and they are apaurusheya, which is mean they are without fault. Because they are not made by the living entity who has 4 defects. These 4 defects are that we don't have, that we have imperfect senses, that we are in illusion, that we are making mistakes, and that we are inclined for cheating. So if one living entity with these 4 defects is going to compose some shastra or something, they will definitely not be perfect and complete. But when Vedas are coming from the Supreme Lord, who is above all these 4 defects, then this all knowledge is without fault, or is apaurusheya. So this system of protection is just that this knowledge stay as it is, as we have Bhagavad Gita as it is. Because so in this way, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was not happy that Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya is changing the verse. But when he heard, he is in one way happy with him, because he see that Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya really became real devotee. He wants just bhakti, he wants to serve him, and he doesn't want anything else, but still he should not change the shastras, because there is proper explanation in the shastras, which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in this particular verse gave to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. So we should also be careful that we are not changing something. Sometimes we can see when devotees are in a kirtan, they have tendency maybe to little bit change some or last part of Mahamantra or something. But what is mantra should not be changed, should be said as it is. And if we have some desire to express ourselves nicely because we are devotional, we can always write the poetry. There is 26 qualities of the devotees, and one of these qualities that Vaishnava is a poet. So we are not just put into one small square, that we are not allowed to say nothing, not express ourselves. No, we can express ourselves. We have so many Vaishnava acharyas who are writing the poems, who are writing very nice and beautiful songs about Lord. But when we have Vedic scriptures, then it should be as it is.